Hi, Excel Legends. What if you have to extract a substring, starting from a specific character or word? Let's say you have message bodies addressed to your customers. These messages include the customer's name and information about their token number. And you need to extract the token number for each customer. How do you do that? It might look tricky, but trust me, it's a breeze. Let's break it down together. Use a combination of Excel's MID and FIND functions. MID function extracts a specified number of characters from a text string, starting from a designated position. FIND function returns the position of a specified text or character within a string, allowing you to locate a specific substring. Let's understand how they work. The MID function takes three arguments. First, the text string. It's the full text from which we need to extract specific text. Here, it's in cell D4. Second, the starting number. It's the exact position of the reference point where our specific text starts. Here, it's the hash symbol we'll use as a reference. Since we need the position and not the reference character itself, we'll use the FIND function as the second argument of the MID function. The FIND function gives the precise location of the reference point. It takes two arguments. First, FIND text, the word or character whose position we need. Here, it's the hash symbol. Second, within text, this is the text string containing our target text, which is in cell D4. The FIND function also has a third optional argument, but we won't need it here. Since we don't want to extract the hash symbol, but use it as a unique reference in all the cells, we'll add +1 to the result of the FIND function. Now the third argument of the MID function is number of characters. This specifies how many characters we want to extract. Here it's 3. Sorted. Press Enter. Yes. Now let's get it done. Drag it down and we're sorted. It is done. Quick tip. The third argument of the MID function is flexible. You can use any number greater than the number of characters you need, as long as there is nothing after your specific text. For example, if the token numbers have 3 characters and there's nothing after them, any number equal to or greater than 3 will work. Let's test it with 100. It's ready. Tap Enter. It's working perfectly. Anyway, it's time to say goodbye. Keep dazzling the world with your Excel vibes. Catch you in the next Excel BizWiz. Take care.